Protesters have brought traffic to a standstill in Melbourne's inner west. The Maribyrnong community is fighting for thousands of heavy vehicles to be banned from suburban streets, saying children's lives are at risk. Emily Angwin has the story.
These little protesters are taking a big stand.
Kids and trucks don't mix.
The trucks are putting poison in the air, which make people sick. They even make my cough worse as well.
Dozens of primary school children joined their parents and other residents rallying against thousands of trucks travelling along their suburban streets. Seven-year-old Edith Dillon was among them.
I think they're really noisy sometimes.
I moved here 10 years ago and there wasn't the volume of trucks then that there are now.
Around 3,000 trucks travel on this road every day, and in the process they pass three schools and a kindergarten.
But Somerville Road isn't the only concern. Residents say thousands of trucks cut through Francis Street in Yarraville, as well as Moore and Buckley Streets in Footscray, to get to the ports every day.
We're calling on the NAPCON government to build proper infrastructure to service the Port of Melbourne with bypass ramps to the Westgate.
And protesters are suggesting a curfew on Somerville Road during school times.
We will have a look at that, but we need to understand what the unintended consequences might be. We may be just moving the trucks from one location to another.
At the moment, there are bans in some areas between 8 p.m. and 6 a.m. Emily Angwin, 7 News.
Meanwhile, residents in Melbourne's inner west have declared war on trucks, claiming they're endangering the lives of their children. They've taken to the streets, imposing a peak hour blockade. Matt Gallant reports.
The busy Somerville Road became a pedestrian walkway as protesters replaced trucks. Local families are supporting the Maribyrnong City Council's call for a curfew on heavy vehicles at the start and end of each school day.
This is an extremely dangerous situation we have here. I've stood here myself and watched trucks run through the pedestrian lights behind me.
There are also fears about the health risks for children who are exposed to diesel fumes.
Kids have developing lungs and they're also outside a lot more than adults, so they're really exposed.
It smells really weird. You want to block your nose.
Disgusting.
Kind of like a dirty kind of dust.
The protesters claim rather than use the Westgate Freeway or the Princes Highway as they head to Melbourne's ports, some truck drivers are doing a rat run along Somerville Road, right past Kingsville Primary.
Over 3,000 trucks travel past this school each day, and parents hold fears that it's an accident waiting to happen.
I've seen them go through red lights at pedestrian crossings for children at school times.
Vic Rhodes says it's not as easy as simply banning trucks.
We may be just moving the trucks from one location to another where it might be worse.
The protesters say this battle has just begun. Matt Gallant, 10 Eyewitness News.
Parents and children have blocked a Kingsville road in a protest over the number of trucks using a busy thoroughfare. They're fed up and fear a child could be struck. Emily Rice was there.
Students recite lines of a different kind during a truck protest just before the school bell.
Kids and trucks don't mix!
They blocked busy Somerville Road while calling for freight curfews during school pick-up and drop-off periods.
I just see lots of cars and trucks crossing over the road. It makes me feel so scared.
We've got 21,000 trucks a day coming through the streets, which are residential streets.
Parents say the trucks are making a rat run to the docks and fear near misses could soon turn fatal.
Trucks have failed to stop at traffic lights on numerous occasions.
I feel quite frightened by it.
I find the whole walk to school pretty horrendous, actually.
In addition to truck traffic, parents are also worried about air pollution and the long-term impact on their children's health.
Protesters also want a bypass constructed so trucks now travelling through residential streets are diverted, instead using the Westgate Freeway and industrial roads to access the port. The Transport Minister says the east-west link will reduce the load.
That's the best thing that could possibly happen for the western suburbs.
And Vic Roads will soon record number plates in the area to track truck movement.
When you really need to understand where those trucks might be going so that we're not just moving a problem from one area to another.
They could just have a day where no trucks are allowed and kids to just be free.
Emily Rice, 9 News.